many themes are relevant in 2021 when it comes to retail and disruption in retail. If we could look historically at e-commerce being the first real challenger, the e-commerce revolution, which represents today a very significant number of retail across the world, has brought a lot of solutions and a lot of changes in business models, whether you're B2C, B2B, the e-commerce enablers, and the logistics, the supply chain, the back end, the fintech, payment, data, and now more and more we're going into artificial intelligence.
We understood the word omnichannel, of course, few years later than we started. I think what we have learned over the time is how one channel can help the other. And that is one biggest learning we had while running this entire show via omnichannel. Today, we feel that, you know, if you want to give a seamless experience to our consumers, one thing which matters the most is that how one consumer can move from one channel to the other as seamless as possible. We are the most downloaded mobile app in eyewear across the world. There are almost close to 4-5 million people who uses our app, but it's mostly for discovery, right? Because the transactions would be just 4-5% out of the number of downloads. But because of that discovery, the overall fashion element, even if somebody is going to a brick and mortar store anywhere, like not necessarily in a Lenskart store, but anywhere, the overall fashion of the entire category is enhancing in a geography like India. The digital era, right? From what was called cost per impressions to moving to cost per click to cost per transactions. And I think the world is today what is cost per experience. And that is how I think in the next 10 years we'll see the world. Slowly, what we call D2C brands today, where there is no middleman. I think in the next 10 years we will see a rage of these brands coming over and taking a significant pie of the market share.
There's a great revolution. Yes, there is, but 87% of a $50 trillion trade that goes across the world, 87% at least of that is still very analog. This number of 87% analog will diminish significantly. Plus some of the things that we rely on in trade, whether it's the letter of credit, which today is a very tedious, ugly tool, but a necessary one, or the different documentations at the port authorities, etc. I think this will be something that we look at in a museum 10 years from now. How can we make sure that we're not reliant on one customer, one country, one region? We're not reliant on this only supplier of logistics. We're not reliant on this only banking partner, etc., etc. And that is really what we're trying to do in this chain.
We're born in the cloud, and then when we had to open store, we had no POS. We had no POS systems, and we were suddenly 100 stores. And we had no systems where you can go and punch out orders. So we were still asking consumers to make order online even after coming to our stores. And the thing which we realized by doing that, which was by accident, was that the same pricing actually works to be way better because consumers' trust is very high, because whether he's buying online or offline, you know, it is immaterial.
Our experience is that price is not important. How silly it sounds. You know, delivery is much more important than availability than price.